ఓ జాతీయ ఛానల్ కి ఇచ్చిన ఇంటర్వ్యూలో తెలంగాణ గవర్నర్ తమిళసై ఏమన్నారో ఒకసారి చూద్దాం.
కరోనా కట్టడికి తెలంగాణ ప్రభుత్వం తీసుకుంటున్న చర్యలపై మీరేమంటున్నారు? సీఎం కేసీఆర్ కోవిడ్ నియంత్రణ చర్యలపై సంతృప్తికరంగా ఉన్నారా?
ది ఫార్మా హబ్, మెడికల్ హబ్, దిస్ స్టేట్ షుడ్ హావ్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ ఇట్సెల్ఫ్ ఇన్ మచ్ మోర్ బెటర్ వే దాన్ నౌ. దట్ ఇస్ మై వ్యూ. Because I am a medical professional, from the day one, I was very cautious and cautioned the government to be very proactive. According to me, there is a clear underestimation of the situation that was there. Actually, now I believe they are in the corrective mode. But initially, I have written almost 6 to 7 letters, and I should say, my views should be taken as sensible advice, not as sensational views. That is my opinion.
మీ సలహాలు సూచనలు తెలంగాణ ప్రభుత్వం పట్టించుకోలేదా?
I said that only for the people's sake I was doing that, and I was only complimentary and contributory, not contradictory. But somehow it was taken in a different way, and it was not taken in a right spirit. If it would have taken in a right spirit, with the infrastructure available in the state, we would have prevented the spread and have combated the virus in much better way, and there wouldn't have been any spike like this, and there wouldn't have been the suffering of patients like this. And really, it's a late takeoff. It's a late takeoff, I should say. And what all I mentioned 3 months back, letter, now they are doing, whether it is racking up of tests, whether allotment of more hospitals for treatment and mobile testing facilities, and allotment of district hospitals, allotment of medical college hospitals, and ramping up of the tests and fever clinics, and identification of containment zones, and home quarantine packages for home quarantine. These all I have written and I have conveyed to the government well ahead 3 months back. Not only they are making it possible. So what I said, my words should have been taken as a grandmother's auspicious words, not stepmother's suspicious words. That is what my humble request.
కరోనా కేసుల వెల్లడి విషయంలో పారదర్శకత పాటించడం లేదంటూ తెలంగాణ ప్రభుత్వంపై విమర్శలు వచ్చాయి. మరి రాష్ట్రంలో జరుగుతున్న పరీక్షలపై సంతృప్తికరంగా ఉన్నారా?
ఆనరబుల్ ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ వెరీ కరెక్ట్లీ హి హస్ మెన్షన్డ్ 80% ఆఫ్ ది పాజిటివ్ కేసెస్ ఆర్ ఫ్రమ్ ది 10 స్టేట్స్ అండ్ మేజర్ కంట్రిబ్యూటర్ ఇస్ తెలంగాణ. మోర్ దన్ 2000 కేసెస్ పై స్టార్టెడ్ విత్ ఓన్లీ 50 కేసెస్ పర్ డే. It crossed 2,600 cases per day. So not only they have granted the test initially, they have permission from the ICMR for private hospitals, but they were hesitant to allow the private hospitals. And there were only 3 hospitals testing for COVID. From the beginning, my appeal was no one should be denied of testing. It's a basic right of a citizen. So if anyone wants to get tested, it was denied for them. So that was the major problem the people of Telangana faced. And I requested for mobile testing, and I requested for district-wise testing.
ఉస్మానియా ఆసుపత్రిలోని పరిస్థితి చూసాం. వైద్య మౌలిక సదుపాయాలకు తెలంగాణ ప్రభుత్వం మరిన్ని నిధులు కేటాయించాలని భావిస్తున్నారు. రాష్ట్రంలో వైద్య సదుపాయాలపై మీ అభిప్రాయం ఏంటి?
Whenever I have met the Chief Minister, I have strongly put my words that this is high time that the infrastructure of the government hospitals should be improved. This is a temple, this is a hope for the poorest and poorest of the people. And as a doctor, I have experienced the suffering of the people in the government hospitals. They are telling now 50,000 beds are available. 80,000 beds are available with oxygen. For quite a long time, approximately 3 months, only one hospital was endorsed for COVID treatment, that is Gandhi Hospital. From distant, 23 district people have to come to Telangana, Hyderabad, to get treated. Then after repeated, not only myself, from the citizen, even the court, Even the court criticized the government, and after that they have allotted so many hospitals. So another thing, they are telling 7,000 doctors are needed, but now 2,200 vacancies are there. They are telling 20,000 beds are available in the hospital, but it needs 20,000 staff, sisters, medical staff, but there are only 4,373 staff nurses there. So it is not available of beds only. It is availability of beds with the infrastructure as well as the medical staff.
ఈ అంశాన్ని ప్రభుత్వం వద్ద ప్రస్తావించారా?
Only for people's sake I am requesting, and I personally convey this message to our honorable Chief Minister of Telangana. You have to improve the facilities in the government hospital, because that is the final hope of poor patients.
ప్రార్థనా మందిరాల్లో కరోనా కేసులు పెరుగుదల చూస్తున్నా. తబ్లిగ్ జమాత్ నుంచి తిరుపతి వరకు కేసులు విపరీతంగా పెరిగిపోతున్నాయి. దర్శనాలకు అనుమతించడంతో తిరుపతిలో కేసులు పెరిగాయి. ప్రార్థనా మందిరాలు తెరవడంపై మీ అభిప్రాయం ఏంటి?
Whatever may be the religious place, whether it is temple or mosque or church, the social distancing should be there. And I feel even the politicians are not following. I am seeing the television news and all. Even the politicians are not following the social distancing, that is physical distancing. They are not wearing the mask. I should say, the name of the mask should be not face mask. It should be nose mask. Nobody is covering the nose. They should know the transmission of virus is through nose and mouth. They are wearing the mask to the chin, to the neck. They are not wearing the mask to the soul. Correct wearing of the mask. The mask itself, some of the countries have proved only by wearing mask, not even testing, 90% they have contained the virus. So wearing the mask should be mandatory. Washing the hands, sanitizer, good physical distancing definitely will break the chain. And with this protective measures, any place, whether it's religious place or it is office or any place, can conduct that program with this protective measure.
దక్షిణాదిలో విపరీతంగా కేసులు పెరుగుతున్నాయి. దక్షిణాది రాష్ట్రాలు ఎక్కడ విఫలమయ్యాయని భావిస్తున్నారు? మీ సలహా ఏంటి?
తమిళనాడు ఫ్రమ్ ద బిగినింగ్ దే డిడ్ అడిక్వేట్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ టెస్టింగ్ అండ్ నౌ దే ఆర్ ఇన్ ఎ డిక్లైన్ మోడ్. సో టెస్టింగ్ ఇస్ మోర్ వన్ థింగ్. అనదర్ థింగ్ ఇన్ఫ్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ ఫ్రమ్ అదర్ స్టేట్స్ అండ్ ది కంట్రీస్ వాస్ మోర్ ఇన్ ది సదర్న్ స్టేట్స్. సో దట్ కుడ్ బి అనదర్ రీజన్. And another thing, the cosmopolitan cities like Hyderabad, Bangalore, Chennai, the containment and the control of COVID was much difficult because of the diversity in the culture and population. So these are the reasons. But treatment wise, discharge wise, and morbidity wise, mortality wise, they are doing well, I should say.
వైద్య నిపుణులుగా ప్లాస్మా డొనేషన్ పై మీ అభిప్రాయం ఏంటి?
The government should go ahead with plasma banking, and plasma donation should be encouraged. And I will motivate the plasma donation, and whatever thing I promote, whatever the suggestions I give, only for the sake of the people, because.